Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So today we're going to talk about slots. So what is slots? Well, slot is a way for us to compose components. What is compose components? Well, in a HTML DOM elements, you can have other elements within your DOM elements, right? You can have a span element within a div element. And you can do the same thing for components as well. You can have other components or other elements within your components. And, well, let's take a look at one example and you'll know. Okay, so here I have prepared an example where I have created a component called component, right? And I'm going to use it over here. So if I said earlier, within a div, you can have other things like text, and span, right, and span element. And inside a component, you can have same thing as well. So I can come over here within a component, I can paste other things within over here. But how does this elements that you created, like you inserted in over here, gonna be used within a component? Well, over here I have a component where the content of component is like components, right? So where do I place in the hello world over here within the component? Well, you can decide your own. You can decide within this component, you can decide where does, if the user of this component provides something as like so-called like a children within my component, then where will the content be go to? Where will the component be inserted into? And you can specify that using a slot. So if I can come over here, say slots over here, component and slots, then you can see that it's slotted after the text called component. If I put it in front, then you can see that hello world component is slotted in front, right? Wherever, so depends on where you have a slot, then there it is where it is being slotted into. And you can actually have multiple of this, right? So slot is like a place where you can insert the content into, and you can have multiple of them if you like too. And if you have other logics within our components, say for example, I'm going to create a variable called show, which you can toggle it on and off using a checkbox. Then if it is true, right? If show is true, I show a slot. If it's not, I will hide it. Okay, so over here, if you see, if I show, I will show the slot. If not, I will hide it. So if I turn on, you will see the slot. If I turn it off, it will be hidden. So this, so within your component, you can control how you want any contents that is being passed within a component inside your component, right? You can, so all this, whatever things that is passing over here, you can control from within a component so that you know that where it will be slotted into. And you use this special element called slot to decide that. And just so that you know that elements over here is nothing but like a normal elements that you can expect that you can write within this app.svelte. I'm gonna create a variable called count equals to 0, and I can show this value over here, count, show the same value over here as well, and I can have a button over here to maybe increment the count. And have another button over here to say decrement it. Right? So this is decrement. This is to increment. So if I show this component, if I click increment, you can see that this is just like just like a normal expressions that you can write within this app.svelte. Got nothing to do with this component. This component just says that where you're going to slot my content in. Right, if I hide, there's no way to slot in, then there be it. If you unhide, you say that, okay, here you're going to be slot in, then yes, you're going to slot it in, right? But then the data inside, the expressions or whatever you have inside, is still be treated like you are rating them within this ML Svelte. You can increment, you can decrement them. And remember when I talk about scope styles, scope CSS, I say that when you have, when you write styles within a component, say for example, if I say button, where the button font size is say 42px, it affects all the buttons within this component file, right? It affects everything within the file. So you have one button over here and one button over here, they'll be both affected. This does not depends on whether this button is, you know, kind of like placed inside somewhere within a this component. It does not matter. The only thing that matters is that this button is written within this file, then your style, your scope style will be affected to the button itself. So now you have a slot and you have components and you can insert content inside. So what if your slots, on the other hand, does not have any content, which is, so over here you write slot to say that, okay, if you have anything within a component, you could just slot it in, right? What if you create another component like this, and you close it immediately so that there's nothing inside, then what happens then, right? So this is the first one. You see, you slot the content in. This is the second one. You slot nothing in, right? Of course, if slot nothing in, then there's nothing. But what if there's nothing and you want to show like a fallback? Well, there, what you're going to do is you're going to have, you can write slots and you can put some content inside. So whatever you pass in over here inside the content, it's like a fallback. It's a fallback content if you have nothing, right? If you have something, then you see something. But if you have nothing, then you'll show the fallback content. So this is one way you can fallback content so that it does not really depends on whether, so it depends on whether like whether the parents pass in something into your component. If there's something, then you slot it in. If there's nothing, then you just show the fallback. So one last thing before I end this video is, what if you have more things that you want to pass into the component? More places to slot into. Right, over here you only have one component called slots, and you can only pass in all the things that is within this component will be slotted in. Right? But what if you have multiple places of so-called placeholders or slots that you want to put things in, and you want to decide where and things like that? What should you do? Well, you can have named slots. So let me remove this, and let's create a few slots. First thing is I'm gonna remove everything first. I'm gonna come here and say this is the header and this is the footer, right? So for example, you have this maybe like a layout component where you create a header and a footer. So, right, and you can allow people to pass in different content for header and different content for footer. Then you can have different slots, right? So if you pass in the same slots over here, then you're getting the same elements into both of the slots. But what if you want different things? Then you can have name slots. You can have name for the slots. Over here, I'm going to name it, call it footer. And then this is a footer name slots. So if you want to pass something to footer, then you can have to come over here. Maybe you create an element for foot, element for footer. And what you do is you're gonna pass in an attribute named footer, and the value will be the name for that slot, right? So this is the slot attribute to determine which element should this slots to be inserted into. So this specify that I'm going to go into the footer slot. This attribute tells you going to footer slot. And over here you have a name slot. You have a name for this slot called footer. And there is where you insert the elements that has a slot attribute called footer in. Right. So by default, a slot without a name is actually named default, right? So you can't have a slot named default, right? This is reserved for the default slot. So yeah, one thing you have to take note about. So you can have name slots and come over here. I'm gonna say this is gonna be a header slot, and now I am going to add this button into the header slot. Right, but I also want to add the count into a header slot. So now what we can do instead is create what I call a slot template, and this allows me to wrap over multiple elements. So I can have multiple elements wrapped within a slot template, and all the elements within here will be part of the slot header because of the attribute called slot header, and they will be inserted into the slot named header. Right, so you can see slot header has 0 and minus, right, a button, and you can have element for footer over here. Right, so you have name slots. So let's recap what we have gone through so far. We can have child elements for your component. Right, and the way where these elements within the component will be inserted will be depends on the slot. Right, slots is where you slot the content in. You can have fallback content for the slot if you pass in like a children within your slots element. And if you want to have multiple slots, you can. But if you want to differentiate from different slots, that like this is the header content for the slot, this is a header slot for header content, and this is a footer slot for footer content, then you can have a name slot. You can provide a name for your slot. And then since you provide a name for a slot, to determine where does the element goes to, which slot that will insert into, you can pass in a slot attribute to name like which slot you go into. So if you slot in only one element, then you can pass it as attribute. But if you want to group multiple elements into the same slot, then you can use a slot template, and same thing, slot attribute to determine which slot name slots you're gonna slot into. And we also talk about styles, where if you have again, just a recap of scope styling, if it affect button, then it will affect all the buttons within this component file, irrelevant whether this is being inserted in like a child component, right? So any button that's written in this file will be affected. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below and click like if you like this button or you learn something, just click like. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.